I'm at least back reporting. But we're here with Virgil Underwater.
Don't say
that. Not what I usually say. Okay. Okay. Mario Barrios, 19-0. How talented is this young kid? 140 is a great division right now.
He's very talented. You know, he's got a great upside. He's the type of kid to keep his head on, right? He's got great character, so I believe he has a great future ahead of him.
What do you like about him?
I like his character. I like his discipline. He's raised right. He has principles. He's very mature for a young man. And he stays practicing his craft. So he stimulates me because he wants it. You know, I don't want it work bad and worse than him. He wants it bad. So he's very stimulating to be around.
In 1 week from tonight, at the exact same time, the entire world will tune in for Andre Ward, Sergey Kovalev 2. For me, it's round 13. It's a continuation from the first one. How does Virgil Hunter see this fight?
A beatdown. That's how I see it. Plain and simple. No other way to put it. However, which way it goes, end up in a beatdown.
It's been a very heated campaign, a lot of trash talking, which usually you and Andre never even say anything negative. I never heard you say anything bad about anybody in my whole life.
We don't. We didn't say anything in this one. The other camp is the one doing all the talking. We haven't said a word. We haven't insulted anyone. We haven't. The only time we answer something is when we ask a question.
Do you take her business that fight? Who would you want next for Andre?
Hard to say. I'm focused on that one right now. You know, but hard to say.
September 16th, Canelo, Gennady Golovkin. How do you see it unfolding?
Right now, as of this day, you know, 50-50. It could change, you know, as you get closer to the fight. But right now, I see it as a 50-50 fight. It's an intriguing fight.
Broner, Mikey Garcia.
That's a tough one to call. So I know Mikey's favorite in the fight, and you know, they talk a lot about his power and things like that. So Broner's going to have to be in the best condition he can be in, and also, you know, have a good game plan. But it's good to fight for boxing also.
A big fight that's going to happen also, maybe August, maybe September, Mayweather-McGregor. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, logic says that Mayweather should win the fight. I guess the intrigue and mystique about the fight is if the other kid can land a punch, or can he land it hard enough to hurt Mayweather, knock him out? I guess that's what it seems like, that's what it's boiling down to.
We just spoke to Nate Diaz on the phone. He was very happy to see you. Obviously, you've seen him in the ring spar, Andre Ward. How good is Nate Diaz's boxing?
Nate could have been doing real well in the professional boxing scene. He's got a lot of talent boxing. Every time we fought a softball, we always brought Nate in because he's competitive and they don't back up. So yeah, he could have been a good boxer, maybe even great if he had just done that, you know, by himself.
What does it say? Andre Ward is a pound-for-pound king. If someone could spar Andre Ward, and it's a good sparring, what does that say about Nate Diaz? If he's sparring the best fighter?
It says a lot. It says a lot of who he is as a boxer. So he always gets that credit from us. We give credit where it's due. We do that.
First of all, have you ever watched Conor McGregor box?
Never have. Should I?
I've seen him, and he does a lot of fundamental mistakes, but if you didn't see him, it wouldn't
happen. Yeah. Should I watch him box before I put money on him?
Now, what is your week going to be like? Because you have a major fight on Saturday. What happens if Virgil Hunter starting Monday morning?
A lot of rest. I'm attending to my boxing. I'm in a lot of rest, a lot of preparation.
For all the trainers watching and fighters, Andre Ward has not lost since he was 12. How do you do it?
It wasn't me, it was him.
No, it's a team. Yes, it was him in the ring, but you're guiding him.
He's got a tremendous will to win, however which way you got to get it. So it wasn't me, it was him. I was just glad to go along for the ride.
Prediction for next Saturday, Ward Kovalev
2? Victory.
Victory. Knockout or decision?
Victory.
There you have it. And Virgil, to end this interview, besides Andre Ward, who do you have as the top five pound-for-pound fighters?
I don't have a list because, you know, each lists change so often. You know, this person got theirs, that person got theirs. I thought at one time there was only one entity that could have the pound for pound list, but now everybody got ESPN, HBO, everybody got a pound for pound list, so it's hard to say, you know, who should be there.
Stay tuned. ESNewsReporting.com. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.